Okay, we can tell this is a male shark externally because of the presence of these elongated claspers on the pelvic fins. So on the inside of the pelvic fins near the cloaca are these two long structures that they use for transferring sperm during copulation. Then the differences internally are fairly minimal. As before, we've previously dissected this animal, and now you can see the pretty much the internal structure is pretty much the same as the female that we looked at. You have this very large liver, three lobes of that, kind of move that to the side with the stomach, and then the small intestine and spleen here. And then as we move that to the side, the real differences with the male are the urogenital system. And so up near the pectoral fins here at the top of the body cavity are a pair of testes. So these white, smooth-looking structures here are testes, one on each side. And then there's a duct that transfers sperm that runs down the surface of the kidney. So remember this raised area right on either side of the spine in the running down the back of the body cavity is the kidney. And you see that runs, the sperm duct runs all the way from the testes down to the cloacal. And then here's the, we'll flip that over. There's testes on the other side. And again, sperm duct running down the kidney to the surface here. These are the beginning of what will be the seminal vesicles that will store sperm before it's transferred. And other than that, those are really the two, those are the major differences between a male and female shark, certainly in terms of their internal anatomy, is primarily in the urogenital system.